Oh, something really bad happened. I'm in Toronto, Canada right now. I've been working on a video for the past week. Started filming it on my trip over here. The video is all about my role as a creator manager and explaining, in my opinion, what I think a great manager does versus what a good manager does. And I don't know what happened. I know everyone's gonna be like, oh, did you turn your computer off and restart it? Or, oh, did you try this thing? I tried everything. I've Googled every solution, get the spinny ball of death, and it just stays there forever. Luckily, I still have all the footage from the video, so I could remake it if I wanted to. Maybe this is the prerequisite of what it takes to be a creator, is to have a moment like this. At least that's the story I'm gonna tell myself. Making content is a very different process to being an operator. It always reminds me of the Casey Neistat maker versus manager schedule, where if you're a manager, you have a very set schedule, you know exactly what you're doing, and I've gotten so used to having my barometer of success on a day come from how many calls did I do, how many docs did I create, or how many tasks was I able to check off today and say that I got completed. And if I was able to do a bunch of tasks, I'd feel super productive, and that was what gave me a lot of self-worth, a lot of validation. And creating content is very different. It's like very open-ended. I can sit with a piece of paper and a pen and try to think of ideas for how to make videos or topics. And sometimes a bunch of ideas will come out, and sometimes no ideas will come out. And you can't really control how creative you're gonna feel or the quality of ideas that you might come up with that day. And that makes content creation very different. And not only that, but you can't get the same sort of validation from it that you do when you're like crushing tasks, because you might spend hours and hours and hours on something and not really get that much further. And so I feel like one of the challenges of going from, you know, being a very task-oriented entrepreneur to being a more free-flowing creator is that I struggle to get the same level of validation from the way that I spend my day. Sometimes I end up like spending a bunch of time scripting, brainstorming, editing, and then I finish the day and feel like I've done nothing. And especially at these early stages when you can spend, you know, 10 hours on a video, 15 hours on a video, and then you post it and hundreds of people see it, it can feel like, was that a good return on investment? And that's totally why I think a lot of content creators give up in the beginning, is because it takes a lot of work and you gotta really like doing it. I think the thing that I'm really grateful for is so far I really enjoyed making these things. Thinking about the way that I'll structure them, adding the music. The part of the process that I've enjoyed the most has surprisingly been editing. The part that I enjoy the least has been filming. I struggle with the social anxiety of like turning a camera on in public, and I'm going to tell myself that this is the prerequisite to being a good creator, is to have an experience where you work on something for a really long time and then lose the file completely. I'm going to try to frame this as a blessing in disguise, where from now on, if I'm interviewing for a new editor, I'm going to see if they can take this footage and create a video that feels similar to the one that I have now lost. Maybe I'm being a crybaby, but I think for the ones out there that have had this happen to them, they know how demoralizing this feeling is. I guess that's it for now. I just wanted to kind of share that. I'll share some other stuff that's gone on while I've been in Toronto. I'm sorry that this happened. I'm beyond... Fuck with me, call him. I don't know. Fuck.
I promise, niggas. I guarantee it. I put my stamp of fucking authenticity, nigga. Ain't no nigga better than me in this fucking planet. I swear to God. Bitch, I'm on my shit again.
I'm about to meet up for brunch with a really good friend of mine. His name is Josh Flexgold. Dean Josh has worked with and managed some of the biggest international musicians and artists in the world, has had his own record label in partnership with Sony. And Josh is also at a very pivotal moment in his life where he is about to have a kid. He just recently was married and is now starting a new chapter in his life. So I'm gonna catch up with Josh, who's also in this period of being an entrepreneur who is reinventing himself. If we're lucky, we'll get Josh to share a bit on what's going on in his life. Josh.
I thought we were going selfie style here.
I'll pull it selfie style too.
Yeah, okay.
What did we just chat about?
Me being lost. You are helping me be found. You are not lost, contrary to your thumbnail.
What is so hard about being at the stage that we're in?
I mean, look, we're at a stage where we're asking, we want to reinvent ourselves. We've done one thing. Now we're thinking about doing something else. And there's a lot of fear associated with that. And I think it's getting over that hurdle of the fear and the judgment from others. And it was nice to hear how you've done that or you're doing it.
Where do you think the fear comes from a lot of people who's in our situation?
I think it's both judgment from others and your peers and people that aren't entrepreneurs, who don't understand, as well as from yourself. And yeah, making excuses, but knowing that deep down you usually know the answer, you know what you got to do. So,
and what's one thing from our conversation that maybe you feel like could help other people who weren't a fly on the wall?
I hadn't thought about the importance of community in which you explained it. And I think it was interesting to hear that building a niche community, you don't have to think about having a million followers, having 10,000 followers, and the way in which you can leverage that community and opportunities that come from it is exponential. Hey.
Love you, brother.
Love you too.
I love this city to death, but the greatest thing I ever did was leave it. And no matter where you're from, here's why I think you should leave your hometown too. See, I grew up in Toronto and moved to Los Angeles right before I turned 25. I didn't know if it would be forever, but I wanted to try something new, and to be honest, I really wanted to get out of the Canadian winters for a bit. But what I discovered was that moving away from home would change my life. And honestly, not because LA is so great, but because moving to a new city does something to you that I think everybody should experience at least once. It opens your eyes to what's possible. You quickly realize that the things that you thought you liked doing weren't really your ideas at all. They were a product of your environment. What jobs you thought were cool, how you wanted to dress, what music you'd listen to. You never really question how much of these things are personal choice or how much they are chosen by those around you. You often grow up making friends because of proximity, friends from school, your neighborhood. While sometimes these friends turn out to be amazing, other times they aren't exactly always the best influence. Being a new city introduces you to a new way of life. You find new friends because of shared interests and values. You pick new habits and activities based on the lifestyle that you want to live. A new city gives you an opportunity to pick what you want and who you want to be. You can always move back home, but even if you do, you'll never be the same because you'll have picked home instead of home picking you.
No. What do I do? R.I.P. It's been almost 48 hours.
And I'm on the verge of giving up, and I've been close to crying. But Erica doesn't want me to. She wants me to move on.
No, I said you can cry if you want.
But then you want me to move on. I'm just not sure I'm ready. I'm at that stage yet. But the project won't load. I've tried everything. Fuck you, spinning ball.